If you look at buildings, architecture, and even the world around you, you'll see that there's one shape that's very, very common in the world, and that's also regarded as one of the strongest shapes, and that is the triangle. The triangle is one of the strongest geometric shapes. It's used in all sorts of things, such as skyscrapers, even the roof of your house, buildings, and even things like the Eiffel Tower. And even everyday things like tripods and all those other things that you use every day. Now, why is the triangle such an important shape, and why is it used in so many different things, and why is it considered one of the strongest shapes? Well, in this episode, I'm going to take you behind the science of the triangle and uncover how all that force is able to be distributed among that triangle, and all the science behind this really, really amazing shape. And it's interesting because triangle is not something that you think would be the strongest shape, but it actually is. So let's get into the science right now. Let's go. Alright, so to understand why the triangle is such a strong shape, and to also understand why it's used in so many different things, we first have to understand two different types of forces: compression and tension. Compression is a force that squeezes things together, and tension is a force that pulls things apart and stretches them out. And these two forces are very, very important when it comes to weight distribution and when it comes to strength, which is what we measure using these triangles when we're saying that triangles are such a strong shape. And the load is what we're talking about, is the amount of weight that something has to support. Let it be a truss or a building or even a bridge. This weight is what it has to support. And this compression and tension are forces that normally happen. And they happen due to gravity and all this weight and all the physics that goes on behind all of this weight supporting mechanisms. But we have to look at the triangle. So when you look at a triangle, all the angles are pretty stable in the triangle. And one of the main things that you can see is that the compression and the tension are evenly distributed. The bottom of the triangle has lots of tension. It's pulling it apart. And the compression is happening across the two sides of the triangle. And that's what causes the entire shape to kind of distort or get squished. But what happens when it gets squished is that it evenly distributes all of that weight. So if you look at something like a truss is just a group of these triangles linked together. And that's what you see on the sides of bridges, even support beams on the roof. And if you look at this truss, you'll see that all the force is being evenly distributed, even though there's so many different triangles that are kind of split apart by these beams and lines. It's evenly distributing all that weight. And that's because of the geometry of the triangle. Because the triangle has these three sides and those fixed angles, it's able to adjust that compression and tension, and that's how triangles are regarded as one of the strongest shapes that we can use, and strongest geometric shapes. That's why they're used in so many things like the Eiffel Tower and so many other architectural marvels. And it's all due to that compression and tension force. And since it can distribute all of these things equally, that's what causes it to be so strong, because it's able to support large amounts of weight, and it also requires less material. When you're talking about building a bridge, for example, every single piece of material is very, very important, because that adds to your budget and your cost. And these bridges can be millions to billions of dollars, and every single dollar counts. That's why using triangles really helps, because it uses less material than, let's say, a square, and it also gives it more strength. If you take a look at a square and you try to put weight on it, it'll either bend or it will just crumble. But when you look at a triangle, those fixed angles that a square or a rectangle doesn't have, those fixed angles and that spreading out of that force, compression, and tension is what helps the triangle be the strongest shape, or one of the strongest shapes. Now, you'll see other shapes like hexagons or cylinders that are also used in nature. You can see them around nature. For example, hexagons being in beehives. Those are also very, very strong shapes, and that's all due to their own kind of aspects, similar to a triangle. But that triangle geometry goes into all of these other different shapes. So that's why triangle is regarded as one of the most strongest shapes, because of all of its properties and all the physics that goes behind it that makes it so that triangle can evenly distribute all that weight and resist this compression and tension forces that act on it. All right, that was a lot of science to unpack right there. So let's review what we learned in this episode. In this episode, we learned that triangles are the strongest shapes because of their ability to resist compression and tension. The size of the triangle helps spread out that compression and tension and the entire pressure of the force acting on top of it. That's what helps triangles become one of the strongest geometric shapes. And this is all thanks to the physics and all of the kind of experimenting humans have done over these thousands of years. You can see this triangle is being used in so many different types of architecture, such as the Eiffel Tower, even the roof of your house, and so much more. Thank you so much for listening to this episode of Spectacular Science. Spectacular Science is produced and hosted by me, Akshay Jayaraman, and our theme song, Lishnu Music, are by Charlie Ramachandran. Visit my website, spectacularsci.com, to find interactive activities, articles, and blog posts. That's spectacularsci.com. If you have a question you want answered on a Spectacular Science episode and get a special shout-out, head over to spectacularsci.com/contact. There you can find a contact form, you can send me your amazing science questions. You can also tag me on Instagram at SpectacularSciPod. That's at SpectacularSciPod. Thank you so much. Also, subscribe to this podcast where you're listening right now. It really encourages me, and you'll be updated on all the new episodes. So go ahead and subscribe and share this podcast with your friends and family. Thank you so much. Thanks for listening, and we'll see you on the next episode of Spectacular Science. Next week, keep thinking about science.